If you didn't see my video or haven't heard, the calendar year 2021 OPPS proposed rule has been released. And let's talk about what's being proposed for evaluation and management services. Watch until the end, and I'll give you information on the 5 steps you need to become a certified marketable medical coder. I'm Clarice Warner, the girl with the pearls, the founder and education director of the Professional Reimbursement Network, LLC, where coding education is key. And on this channel, I provide you with information, tips, and strategies on how to become a certified marketable medical coder. As a result of my straightforward strategies, tips, and optimistic approach to education and learning, I've helped hundreds of students become certified medical coders who have developed dynamic careers in the business of healthcare and are valuable resources in their own right. Subscribe to my channel to get the latest and greatest information and tips you need to become a certified marketable medical coder. And don't forget to hit the bell for notifications of my weekly videos. For the last couple of years, CMS has been working hard to assist providers with the documentation burden. The Patients Over Paperwork Act was implemented primarily for that specific task. Last year, the AMA introduced sweeping changes on how to level evaluation and management services in the outpatient setting, and CMS signed on. Evaluation and management services are taught extensively in our online medical coding course. And if you are interested in information regarding our online medical coding course, well, let me invite you to an online live Q&A session Saturday, August 29th at 10 a.m. Eastern Standard Time. To register, see details in the description box. And check this out. Are you confused about all the medical coding programs, but unsure what to ask? Do you want to make sure you get everything you need to learn medical coding and become certified? Well, join me on the last Saturday of every month at 10 a.m. Eastern Standard Time, where I will answer your burning questions regarding medical coding. Join our monthly medical coding course Q&A session. To join us, click the link to register.
Can't wait to see you.
Well, guess what? It looks like it is full steam ahead for those evaluation and management changes. There was nothing proposed in the calendar year 2021 OPPS proposed rule that will alter the course of those new guidelines for evaluation and management services going into effect in 2021. There was one proposal affecting evaluation and management services regarding prolonged visits, and let's discuss what is being proposed. Let me first say that the actual code is still under construction, and as such, in the proposed rule, the code is referred to as 99XXX, prolonged office or other outpatient evaluation and management service beyond the total time of the primary procedure, which has been selected using total time, requiring total time with or without direct patient contact beyond the usual service on the date of the primary service, each additional 15 minutes. And you would list this separately in addition to CPT codes 99205, 99215, for office or other outpatient evaluation and management services. So CPT code 99XXX is only reported when time is used to select the visit level, and only time of the physician or qualified healthcare professional is counted. In the calendar year 2020 PFS final rule, CMS stated that their interpretation of revised CPT prefatory language and reporting instructions would mean that CPT code 99XXX could be reported when the physician's or MPP's time is used for code level selection and the time for a level 5 office or outpatient E&M visit. The floor of the level 5 time range is exceeded by 15 minutes or more on the date of service. The intent of the CPT editorial panel was unclear because of the use of the terms total time and usual service in the CPT code descriptor, requiring total time with or without direct patient contact beyond the usual service. That's what it said. The term total time is unclear because office and outpatient E&M visits now represent a range of time, and total time could be interpreted as including the prolonged time. Further, the term usual service is undefined. There is no longer a typical time in the code descriptor that could be used as a point of reference for when the usual time is exceeded for all practitioners, and there would be variation as well as potential double counting of time if applied at the individual practitioner level. Having reviewed the policy CMS finalized last year, CMS believed that allowing reporting of CPT code 99XXX after the minimum time for the level 5 visit is exceeded by at least 15 minutes would result in double counting time. As a specific example, the time range for CPT code 99215 is 40 to 54 minutes. If the reporting practitioner spent 55 minutes of time, 14 of those minutes are included in the services described by CPT code 99215. Therefore, only 1 minute should be counted towards the additional 15 minutes needed to report CPT code 99XXX, and prolonged services should not be reported as was finalized last year. Therefore, CMS is proposing that when the time of the reporting physician or MPP is used to select office or outpatient E&M visit level, CPT code 99XXX could be reported when the maximum time for the level 5 office or outpatient E&M visit is exceeded by at least 15 minutes on the date of service. And there were two new tables in the proposed rule. Table 22 is for new patients and table 23 for established patient. And let's take a look at them.
For 60 to 74 minutes, you would code 99205. For 89 to 103 minutes, 99205 and 99XXX times 1. For 104 to 118 minutes, it's 99205 and 99XXX times 2. And then for 119 minutes or more, you're looking at 99205 and 99XXX times 3 or more for each additional 15 minutes. For the established patient, 99215 is for 40 to 54 minutes. For 69 to 83 minutes, it's 99215 and 99XXX times 1. For 84 to 98 minutes, it's 99215 and 99XXX times 2. And then for 99 minutes or more, 99215 and 99XXX times 3 or more for each additional 15 minutes. Remember, the total time is the sum of all time, including prolonged time spent by the reporting practitioner on the date of service of the visit.
Well, there you have it. Don't forget, if you have comments, you can submit your comments electronically to http://www.regulations.gov. Follow instructions under the Submit a Comment tab or use the search box and use CMS-1736-P. You have until October 5th, 2020 to comment. You have learned that the CMS calendar year 2021 OPPS proposed rule was released, and there is nothing proposed that will change the plans to revise the Evaluation and Management Outpatient Services Guidelines in 2021. You have learned that CMS is proposing a clarification of how to use the prolonged services code 99XXX. And lastly, you have learned that I am hosting a live Q&A session on Saturday, August 29th at 10 a.m. Eastern Standard Time to answer your burning questions regarding our online medical coding course. Check the link in the description box to register. Question of the day. Have you been preparing yourself and your providers for the new outpatient evaluation and management services changes? Let me know in the comments below. And if you haven't checked out our video, check these out. We have a full slew of the information regarding the changes. I'm Clarice Warner, the girl with the pearls, the founder and education director of the Professional Reimbursement Network, LLC, where coding education is key, providing you with information, tips, and strategies on how to become a certified, marketable medical coder. If you are interested in more information on these tips and others on how to become a certified, marketable medical coder, well then check out these videos and check this out. Are you interested in medical coding, but not sure where to start? And scared of wasting time and resources? Let me help you with the right steps to become a certified, marketable medical coder. Learn more at bit.ly/5stepscoder. If you liked this video, don't forget to let me know by hitting the thumbs up, hitting the subscribe button, and the notification bell so you are informed every week when I upload new content. I love hearing from you. So let me know you were here by providing a comment or question. I do read all the comments and questions and I respond. You can also give me a little love by sharing this video on your social media platforms. Let's stay connected and connect others. Remember, be safe, be kind, and don't wish for it, work for it. Until next time, take care and thanks for watching.